All right, well, hopefully my mic works. It got a little wet. Audio equipment and water never really mix. I'm at Orange Lake today. We have a tournament here in 1 week. It's still going on. We're going to do the social distancing thing. Online captain's meeting. Show up, fish, go home. Everything's verified, and on Tuesday, they'll do the virtual ceremony. This place looks a lot like Kissimmee and Fellsmere. You know, there's a ton of hydrilla. There aren't necessarily lanes or chutes that I can see besides like a few boat lanes, but there is a ton of hydrilla, which I can now totally understand why. You know, this lake constantly produces trophy quality fish. It's going to be kind of hard to get them out of here. Now, there's a few places I've read that are good. I'm going to head over to McCormick Island. I'm at Bird Island, I believe it's called. I'm going to head over to McCormick Island. I'm not sure where the gator hole is. I heard that's a good spot as well. But this pre-fish is really just to kind of familiarize myself with the area. Not necessarily locate and pattern fish today. Because we just had a front come in last night. Yesterday it rained. And so it's cooler today. It's quite a bit cooler than normal. We've been having these 80, 90 degree days, and right now it is about 59, 60 degrees, and it's gonna warm up. It's gonna be a big swing, about a 20 degree swing. It's gonna warm up to about 80 degrees today. But next week, they're forecasting rain for the beginning of, the weekend, and most of next week actually, like scattered showers and things like that. So if that's the case, you know, the fishing is going to be completely, completely different than it was, than it is today. On top of that, so I'm not really relying on any pattern stuff today. You know, I'm going to throw some spinner baits. I'm going to throw a couple swim baits and a worm, but I want to get over on this island here. There's a boat there. There's a boat over there, and there's a boat back there towards the boat launch. I want to keep track of where those guys are at. Kind of figure out, you know, is this where I want to be? Is this where they're catching the fish? That kind of thing. Oh, that's a giant wake. I have no idea what it was. That's probably a gar if it got that close. That's probably a gar. Cormorant over here chasing these bait fish around. I mean, it's always a good sign when they're around that usually means there's fish in the area. Well, I just had one on. I'm not sure what it was. Set the hook. He was on for about 2 seconds and then he came off. Usually been a gar just grabbing the skirt of this spinner bait. I had one. Really sure where the fish are at or what they're doing. They had this, you know, one wake this morning and one bite, and I'm not really seeing other people, you know, hauling in any. So I think I'm gonna drift down here, get all this stuff, and there are fish being pushed around. I mean, it's mostly like gar that are pushing little bait fish and stuff. I haven't seen any bass activity yet. So the problem I'm seeing right now is like this water is really stained. I mean, there's probably maybe a foot and a half, two foot of visibility. But it's pretty deep here. It's probably 6-7 feet. This is not like some of the other lakes that look like this are, you know. West Lake Toho is fairly shallow in many areas. I think the deepest it gets is maybe 10 to 12 feet. So it's pretty shallow. You know, it averages around that 3, 4, 5 range. A lot of the places I fish aren't very deep on there. Keenansville and Fellsmere, you know, those are all at most, maybe most places 3 to 4 feet deep. One thing I want to note is there's like 4 or 5 boats down in this corner here. I'm not saying that they're catching anything, but if they are, it's worth going to check out. Well, I'm going to see if I can find something back here. The water looks a lot better back here in terms of visibility. It just had a bite. Not sure what it was. I don't think it was very big. I think it grabbed it and started swimming up before I set the hook and let go. I've seen a few gar and a bowfin. Nothing that I'm looking for. The guys, they were all piled up after. They're fishing for crappie. So, let me see if I can get back into some of these shallow areas. Maybe just find some bass pushed up. Alright, this is the spot I wanted to get to. I don't know if it'll be any good or not, but I'm going to try it. The other option I have after this is head out and hit those hydrilla fields and fish all the holes in between the hydrilla. I mean, there's a lot of bait fish back here. It's not very deep though. I did just have a boat roll through, but it was one that sits up pretty high. Back here is definitely shallow, but the water is really clean. Well, most of this looks like it's just a big shallow flat. I was kind of hoping this would be kind of a hole back here. It's a little bit deeper, but I haven't seen much. I'm going to push up a little bit more and then head out into the hydrilla, I guess. Got no other option. There's like zero activity back here. If there are any fish in here, they can't be big. There's like no bait fish. I mean, there's structure, but it's not deep enough to mean anything. So I'm gonna go ahead back out and go towards the boat ramp. Hit all those holes in the hydrilla. See if we're gonna find some better water. I mean, the water back here is good. I mean, we want clear water if we can find it, or clearish water. The water that's out there where I was fishing this morning is dirty. Well, I didn't get skunked, and that was a big old bowfin right there. On the chatterbait, I figured I'd put on something that vibrates pretty hard and work this. There's a lot of hydrilla out here. I'll work this edge over here. He came up and hit, and I thought it was a bass. I just saw the mouth. Well, it's a good thing he's off, though, because I don't want to try to take those off. I don't have my grippers with me. Well, I just, off camera, just missed it. Hooked into another mudfish. I mean, the fish are biting, it's just the wrong ones. Gar, between gar and these two mudfish I've had, it's just staying it. He grabbed it right at the boat. Well, didn't get skunked. And, you know, those bowfins, they didn't really hit the bait super aggressively either. They kind of waited till the last minute. That's not typical of them, but, I mean, it's not untypical of them, but still, I'm wondering, again, if that front really has the fish put off, and they might start feeding heavy again tonight. We're about as hot as we're going to get right now, but clear skies, the breeze died down. So, let's keep fishing around, see if we can't find some fish. I like to look at this spot over here, but it's still pretty deep here. It's, you know, it's more than 6 foot right here. Okay, so I'm over by the boat ramp. There is quite a bit of fish activity over here. It's nothing big. But I think I'm going to stick with the plan that I came up with and, you know, I'll fish this area and not too far from the boat ramp. I know, and there's a bunch of fish that jumped right there. It's just weird that the bass aren't hitting, you know. I figured at least by now they'd turn on. Just there's a few boat fin and there's a couple hits this morning on them. One on the worm and then a couple on spinnerbait. I know a few of them were gar. But, yeah, I mean, the dynamic of this lake is going to completely change by next week, too. I know that that's going to be a fact. We have a big storm system pushing through, and it's going to push a low over top of us, or just to our north, and we're going to get scattered thunderstorms and stuff all week. But that's what's projected to be. It may change, but today it was like 58 degrees when I got to the ramp. And it's been, you know, 80, 90 degrees every day, except for today. Today's going to be the coolest, and it's because the front came through last night. So I'm assuming that has messed with the fish just enough to not make them super active. Yeah, so not really 100% sure what to make of today. These pre-fish videos are kind of killing me. Every single one I've been skunked in, and it's usually rare for me to get completely skunked. I mean, I didn't get skunked today. I caught two bowfin, if you want to call that. But just, oh well. You know, next week, conditions, I guess, like I said, are going to be completely different. So we'll see what happens, and we'll try to formulate from there. But I think, you know, this is probably the best spot is down in this area. I don't want to make a long run, especially if, like, we have thunderstorms rolling up. And, you know, most people say they catch fish in this area. This is what I've been reading. And there's obviously going to be bass here. There's plenty of bait fish. I just don't see any bass activity today. And I'm not 100% sure why. But you know, hopefully we'll figure it out by Saturday, and we'll give it my best shot. So, sorry if the video isn't that exciting, but it is what it is. I'll catch you guys in the next one. I'll see you at the tournament.